गुड इवनिंग टू
टीचर।
ऑल, नमस्कारम।
I think we are live, Paula.
Yeah.
So,
shall we start recording?
Yes. So now, shall I disable the waiting so that
everybody
can join?
Yes, yeah, I'll do that. And Ramesh, just make sure Kritika also comes online soon. She's here. Kritika is also here. Okay, yeah. Over to you, Paula.
Thank you. So hello and welcome to all the dignitaries and my fellow optometrists. It is our privilege to host this award ceremony as it is the first virtual award ceremony by Optometry Council of India and of course a landmark for us. With the lockdown because of the pandemic, with schools and colleges getting closed and classes happening online, educators really had a very tough time, and I'm sure optometry educators were not spared. It was very thoughtful of the OCI board to celebrate our optometry educators and introduce the Best Optometry Educator Award. I would like to introduce today's invitees and the applicants as well. We have Ms. Lakshmi Shinde, of course, our CEO, our beloved CEO. We have Mr. Sanjay Bhutani from Washilong. Hi, Sanjay sir.
Hi,
we have Kemraj. Hi, Kemraj. We have KK sir, Dr. KK. Hello, KK sir. And all the applicants have not yet joined, so still I will announce their names who are missing. People who are present can just wave their hand so that everybody who is watching can know that yes, you are there. We have Ms. Hiral Korani, Mr. Divakar, Mr. Noor, Mr. Usman, Ms. Kritika, Ms. Tabamati, Mr. Avinash, Mr. Ankit, Ms. Shenmugam. Okay, I think Shenmugam is missing.
Shenmugam is
missing. And we also have our OCI board members joining. We have Pema ma'am joining us. And we are also waiting for other board members to join us. I would like to share a presentation.
Paula, before you start presenting or sharing the screen, it will be good for maybe you can call out the name. And the person can say from which educational institution they are, and so that you know all of us know from where they're teaching. So maybe one by one you can call out the name and they can introduce themselves.
Yes. So whoever is in my screen first, I will call their name, not in alphabetical order. So I have Avinash Prabhu. Hi, Avinash.
Yeah. Hello, ma'am. Good evening to all. My name is Avinash Prabhu. And I'm currently working as assistant professor at the M.S. Ramaiah University of Applied Sciences. And since past 1.5 years. Thanks.
Thank you, Avinash. Then we have Mr. Divakar Rao. Hi, Divakar.
Hi. Good evening, all of you, for the respected panel members. And I'm working as an assistant professor at Shankara College of Optometry. Affiliated to Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Science in Bangalore.
Thanks, Divakar. We have Ms. Tabamati. Hi, Tabamati.
Hi, good evening, everybody. Myself, Tabamati. And I'm working as an assistant professor in Manipal College of Health Professions, Mahe, Manipal.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Then we have Ankit. Hi, Ankit. Ankit Varshne. Ankit, can you hear us? Okay. We have Mr. Usman Menon. Usman sir, can you please switch on the video? Hi.
Good. Hi. Good evening, everybody and panelists. I'm Usman Menon, faculty at Nagar School of Optometry, affiliated to Gujarat University, Ahmedabad.
We have Ms. Hiral Kurani. Hi, Hiral, can you put on your video? I think she's traveling.
Hiral, can you unmute and talk? Is that okay? Okay, let's move on.
We have Ms. Kritika. Hi, Kritika, can you switch on the video, please? Hi.
Hello, everybody. Myself, Kritika. I'm working as an associate professor from Manipal College of Health Professions.
Thank you. And we have Noor. Hi, Noor.
Hello, ma'am. Hello, everyone. Myself, Dr. Nuruzama. I am a assistant professor at Shankara College of Optometry, Ludhiana, Punjab.
Thank you, everybody. So I would like to share a presentation. I am just sharing my screen. Is my screen visible?
Yes, yes, Paula.
Yes, so I'm formally again reintroducing ma'am, Ms. Lakshmi Shinde. She's a CEO of Optometry Council of India. And ma'am, I would like you to just give a concept, give everybody the information of conceptualizing this award and just share your thoughts.
Hello, everybody. Welcome from Optometric Council of India. So for the past 2 years, we've been initiating a few awards for World Optometry Day, which is in March. And those are Best Optometrist of the Year, then Best Case Report, and also towards the public health services. But some, like from the beginning of this year, we were thinking it will be best to kind of initiate an educator award, especially because of the tough times that students as well as educators were going through for the past few years. And also we didn't have any platform to kind of recognize the contribution that educators are making. And I think it's high time we all value the inputs that the educators give towards the profession and also shape the optometry future in a way in terms of educating the next generation of people that will be practicing optometry in the near future. So that's the reason we kind of thought of this. And of course, I did have a chat with Kemraj and shared this idea, and we both together kind of said, okay, the best time to maybe announce this was Teacher's Day. And this idea was actually Kemraj's. So all credit to you, Kemraj. The idea came from him saying, if we can announce for applications during that time, and then after that, go through the process of the applications, receive applications, and have a person to judge it. And then after that, announce the award. Of course, we were thinking of World Sight Day, but I think because of the festival time that the World Sight Day, came through, we decided let's, have it the week following that. And that's why today. So, no matter who is winning the award today or, who is not getting, I think each one of you who have applied for it is definitely, deserving all the credit, because education is definitely getting tougher and tougher. I'm not saying in terms of learning, I'm saying in terms of teaching, because as students, I think they're so, open to all the gadgets, all the internet information that's available and all of that. So concentration, within inverted commas, is becoming tough. Maximum is 5 to 10 minutes that you can catch the attention of the student, and then you lose them. So it's a very, very tough job that all of you are doing. So congratulations, first of all, to each and every one of you that are here, recognize all of you and all your contributions that you've made. And I think this award is a very, very small gesture because I think the contribution all of you have made, and especially the changes, you know, overnight all of you had to change from classroom to a virtual teaching. And then, I know that many of you have actually gone out, personally called students, spoken to them, because everybody was very tense in the situation, how they're going to cope, when is the college going to open, what is the exam pattern, and then coming up with all kinds of new methods of assessments that all of you have done for the past 1 to 1.5 years. Hats off to each one of you in this process, entire process. So thanks for being part of this entire process. And over to you, Paula.
Yes.
And before Paula starts, I also would like to thank Dr. KK, who, you know, I think it was unanimously chosen by the board as well as us, saying that the person who can judge all these applications is him, with all the extensive background that he's had in teaching and also leading the, the school, Elite School of Optometry. So he was the judge for the entire process. So thank you, KK, for accepting that as well.
Thank you, ma'am. Acknowledging someone's contribution to society is always important. It honors the achievements of passionate and hardworking individuals and gives an inspiration to those who would follow their example. This is exactly what our sponsors feel, and OCI is ever and forever grateful to Bausch & Lomb India Private Limited to support this award. I would like to formally introduce and invite Mr. Sanjay Bhutani to say a few words on this occasion. Sir, before you start, I would just like to share screen so that I can just share your profile with everybody. Just give me a second. So a small introduction of Mr. Bhutani. Mr. Sanjay Bhutani is the Managing Director, India and SAARC, Bausch & Lomb India. He has been with Bausch & Lomb since 2006. Mr. Sanjay has led a series of leadership positions in the company, most recently as Managing Director, India and SAARC of Bausch & Lomb India, a Bausch Health Inc. company since 2013. Mr. Sanjay completed his PGDM from Indian Institute of Management, Calcutta. He is associate member of Institute of Cost and Works Accountants of India and Institute of Company Secretaries of India. He has also done LLB from Delhi University, national board member of AmCham India, co-chairman CII National Medical Technology Forum, board member MTAL and committee member FICCI. Over to you, sir, and thank you for sponsoring this award.
You're muted, Sanjay ji, you're muted.
So thank you so much, Paula, for that lovely introduction. But before I start, I want to really thank Lakshmi, Paula, the entire OCI board for the love and passion they have towards the profession. No? While Lakshmi ma'am was saying like it's small thing, but I think every small thing counts, and it shows the really work you're doing for taking the profession to a next level. And I was just kind of chatting with her before the conference started, that now I see you more often on maybe some pictures or videos on Facebook, doing something or the other for the fraternity, or maybe for the patients to take the maybe eye health even to a higher level. Also, thank you to all the panelists on this call. Before I start, I'm really delighted to see the commendable work optometrists are doing across the country in delivering the quality eye care to people of India. So during one of the Bausch & Lomb CSR program, and this is again like we have association with OCI, which goes like long back, which was named Experience Vision. And I learned the great passion you all have towards the noble profession. I know many of you are involved in community eye screening in order to in order to ensure eye care reaches to all the sectors of the community. The optometrists working in private practice are actually raising the bar of the eye care delivery by including comprehensive eye examination in their practice and introducing latest technology in order to aim the best eye care solution for the patient. I also see optometrists taking diverse roles like Cayman and the entire PS team in our company is a good example, and spreading their presence across like various domains, like some of you are working with NGOs, helping corporates, mastering academic educators, many of you're already on there on this panel, and this list kind of goes on and on. Many of them are also actively involved in strategy and decision making in their respective roles. So one might be person might be working in a corporate, he might be working on a different strategy to think, how do we kind of maybe make that company more successful. But people, for example, the OCI board, they work on a different strategy, how to kind of make the profession look much bigger. So everybody is kind of actively involved in some strategy or the other in decision making in their role. So which is really heartening to see. And all this is testimony to great impact optometrists can create in delivering quality eye care in India. Coming to like Bausch & Lomb and maybe its relationship with education. Education is the best tool anyone can have to shape their future better. In fact, when I keep talking to my team, I say people who are like technically qualified are the best people to sell in the market. So if you are selling on price, that's not where you need to be. So you should know like what are the benefits and advantages of your product, for which you need to maybe learn about the technical details of the product you are selling. So we at Bausch & Lomb strongly believe in continuously educating and making eye care professionals more capable in dispensing right contact lenses to patients, making them to see better so that they can live better. And our logo is also see better, live better. So education has been core of our DNA at Bausch & Lomb since inception. And I joined in 2006, but I've got stories from the time like the company came to India and we were like the first one in 1992 to set up a plant for contact lenses and lens care solution. And when we entered like 29 years back, one of our top priorities was creating opportunities for practitioners to educate themselves on contact lenses. So because when we came here in India, we saw like not many people are aware of contact lenses. So we as a market leader thought it's better to kind of maybe start at a grassroots level where we start teaching or maybe educating people about contact lenses. And that was the time when we partnered with the very prestigious L.V. Prasad Institute for creating the contact lens education program, which is called ICLEP and still kind of running. This was, I think, year 1993. And even today, it's like one of the most successfully running contact lens education program. Bausch & Lomb, in fact, to support LVPI Institute in setting up the School of Optometry in Hyderabad was around that same time in 92, 93, I think, and which also shows our commitment towards the education. So even today, passion for education has further grown, whether it's like kids in the school or maybe people in the college or maybe people or professionals like us. So education sees is like maybe no age barrier. And in fact, if you look at the curriculums in any school now, people say every 5 years the curriculum changes and people should go back to school. So I'm sure, yeah, also like you or most of you would be aware that Bausch & Lomb has the biggest team of optoms as professional services team, working very closely with all of you in order to provide latest and updated contact lens education to our practitioners, so that Bausch & Lomb remains at top of education or maybe are recognized as the topmost partner in education of every contact lens practice in India. Our education programs like Mastermind has sustained thousands of ECPs by now who are confidentially dispensing contact lens in their respective practices. This award, and thank you, Lakshmi ma'am, for coming out with that idea. I know Kim was just kind of maybe there, but I think the idea just came in from OCI for the Best Optometry Educator of the Year award. And we started in 2021. Hopefully, we'll carry on with this legacy, which aims to recognize the commendable effort of optometry educators, the work they are doing, and in order to transform optometry students into greater professionals. India need more trained professionals in order to meet the overgrowing demand of qualified eye care professionals. Specifically, now I think the world is talking about India might become the myopia capital of the world. So the role for us would become even larger, and the optometry educators are playing a significant role in achieving this goal. I again like congratulate OCI for conceptualizing this unique award for optometry educators, and we are very happy to support this vision. I also congratulate all the applicants who came forward and applied for this award, and wish you all the luck for today's award ceremony. But may the best one win, should win. And then thank you, and wishing you all a great evening ahead and best of luck. Thank you, Paula. Over to you.
Thank you, Sanjay. And, I was about to say that we are hopeful that your support continues for the years to come. So we look forward for your support for, such kind of events. I think Shaun Raj, who's also an applicant, joined us later. Shaun Raj, do you want to introduce yourself?
Yeah, thanks, Lakshmi. I'm Shaun Raj, working as an associate professor at Manipal Academy of Higher Education. That's shortly about me. Thanks, Lakshmi.
Okay. I think, Manipal should be very proud of themselves that we have quite a few applicants from the same university. So that's really nice. And also alumni of Manipal educators as well. So yeah, good show by all of you. Over to you, Paula.
Thank you, ma'am. Okay. It was overwhelming for us to receive a lot of applications for this award, and the best 10 were selected out of them. To judge those applications, the OCI board decided to rely on none other than one of the country's renowned educators himself, Dr. Krishna Kumar Ramani. Sir, I would take this opportunity to formally introduce you and invite you for sharing your thoughts, please. I'll do a slide share. Just give me 1 minute. Dr. Krishna Kumar Ramani is presently working as a freelance optometrist and educationalist, as well as contributing as a mentor for occupational optometry services and faculty member at Sankara Mitralaya and Elite School of Optometry, respectively. He also serves as an advisor for Arvind Fellowship in Optometry, Arvind Eye Hospitals, Chennai, and Optometry Council of India. He did his undergraduate, postgraduate, and doctoral degrees from Elite School of Optometry, run in collaboration with Birla Institute of Technology and Science, Pilani. He also possesses a master's in psychology and a fellowship in British Dispensing Optics. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Paula, for the nice introduction. Hope I'm audible.
Sir, yes, sir, you're audible. Just before that, I make a quick comment, sir. Sorry about that. Lakshmi said there are many alumni from Manipal, but I'm just looking at the participants list. There are many of us are your students, sir. So we are proud students of you. So I'll put that as an introduction to you as well. So thank you. Go ahead, sir.
Good point, Shaun Raj. Very good point.
Thank you, Shogan, and all wonderful educators. So I take this opportunity to congratulate all the educators who nominated themselves or been nominated for this prestigious OCI Bhushan Lam Educator Award. And on behalf of all the educators, I like to thank OCI and Bhushan Lam for coming forward, and especially Cambridge for putting forth this wonderful idea. And really, I feel on behalf of all the educators, I would like to make a special thanks to you. And thank you very much, OCI, for giving me the opportunity to go through the documents submitted by all educators. The first reaction going through that is I felt that things have really changing in a faster way. And it is wonderfully aligning with the changing scenario of expectation from the students of optometric education. And especially I try to concentrate in all your documents the area of innovation, as well as what for doing that, or applying that innovation, what is that you did for yourself? Because a lot of time what happens is we become more enthused with attending some short-term programs and immediately jump to apply it. The process of applying something innovation new into an education always required some kind of thought process, some kind of teamwork, discussion, and then it should get into the practice. And only then we can see the whole gamut of not only yourself, but gamut of your colleagues, faculty, will come together and participate in it, so that you know the pros and cons and keep on progressing and refine it further and further. I could see that kind of innovative approach. Especially I was impressed with most of you gone through some short-term program, but I'm very much impressed with at least two of them who have gone through an extensive fellowship program given by FIMER. FIMER is the foundation of advancement of international medical education and research. It was nice to go through it. And then whatever you learned and try to apply into your teaching methods. And I always felt that you also would have interacted with your colleagues who couldn't go through this FIMER program. And therefore you try to ensure that all of them on the same bandwagon. I was really thrilled to see that, and I'd like to congratulate two of them who have did the FIMER. And I also congratulate who have put some initiative towards training yourself into various pedagogy and personal advancement programs. Only to ensure that you want to give the best of education to your students. I feel that way. I feel really proud to see great educators, young people who are getting involved in themselves. When people say that there are a lot of attractive means are available in clinical practices, and I see this young, wonderful educators dwelling into education field, as well as trying to ensure that you keep incorporating newer techniques to ensure the learning process among the students. So I feel that usually I strongly feel innovation in education, especially in optometric education, I feel there should be the foundational knowledge imparting is very, very important. I see a lot of your innovation technique dwell upon it. And you didn't stop with that. You also looked into how to ensure these things get implemented. But one of the aspect which probably I feel it didn't come out, but I thought it will be more appropriate platform for me to think, because the skill component of it and the analytical component of it, and though there are few here and there, approaches have been shown by some of you, but I feel somewhere a team effort of all these educators coming together, at least after this, maybe OCI can facilitate that process, sit together and see whether you can refine. And I know that the Oculus program from Erasmus, I think some of the institute work towards that. Probably it can be extended. Maybe Dr. Kritika, I saw some of the Manipal team worked on it, University of Hyderabad worked, Chitkara University, Shankara, all these people worked. I feel this is the high time. You can just see how, along with the OCI partnership, whether you can spread this, the knowledge which you gain to more and more schools, that will be a phenomenal thing that you can contribute towards education in this country. The one of the important aspect which I felt, and I think all of the educators definitely would have gone through our national educational policy. I feel don't stop with reading the chapter on higher education. I strongly feel you should read right from the first chapter onwards, because the school education is actually the feeder for all our higher education. Probably you can see how the creativity, innovative, and what are the expectation you have can be linked with the school education, because the present system, which we are going to adapt in the national educational policy, we are going to have more and more creative and more appropriate students towards in optometry and many other fields. And in terms of how this field is expanding, I strongly feel since the technology is enabling most of the process, there is a confusion in many educators. Is it worth to teach some of these things? I feel you people should come together, try to brainstorm and see what are the changes you have to bring. But I have only one thing to add on to all these things. There are two important aspects. I feel it is going through some, I don't know whether I use the right word, vulnerability, because people try to keep it away. The purpose for which this need to be done or need to be focused is actually getting deviated. I feel the only scope or hope I have is on the educators' side. The two important areas. One, lot of us, we try to treat, say, for example, simple condition like myopia. Gorshalom MD was talking about the importance of myopia. I think all of us were well aware of myopia. But how many of us really worried or concerned about the family who have got a child first time going for any of this intervention which we are going to talk, and what kind of psychological phenomenon they are going through? Are we trying to impart that? Are we inculcating that into our practice? Something which I strongly feel that we should try to do it, not only for myopia, even whatever the correction we provide, try to see the other dimension of an individual who are going to use it, an equipment which he feels which is attached with a different kind of stigma in the society. So how to really, as an optometrist, you can contribute. So somewhere at that educational aspect, because many have been taught a psychology, I feel somewhere we have to link two aspects, our health beliefs and the behavior, and the illness belief and our behavior. Somewhere that focus on this, and whenever you teach an ocular disease, whenever you teach any of these, binocular vision anomalies, all this thing goes with this behavior. I feel that will transform more and more people to accept your intervention in a very effective way. Somewhere I feel the education system of today in optometry having concentrated much. I think other things on technology, I think a lot of people are talking about, AI, we are talking about data science. I feel a lot of great schools of optometry has already started inculcating it. Probably that is the one message to all the educators. Again, I take this opportunity to congratulate each one of you and ensure that you continue to pursue this area and try to give us more and more a better solution for better care, optometric care in this country. Once again, thank you, OCI, and Barshalam. Thank you, Barshalam, for your continuous support. Thank you.
Thank you, KK sir. As an organization, we have always been open for suggestions, feedback, opinions from our members and the fraternity. And today I am going to use this platform to hear from all the applicants. I'm sure your feedback and opinions will help us improve our future actions. I will ask few questions to all the applicants, but before that I wanted to share the screen. Ma'am, is it okay if I if a slide presentation is not there and we start communicating?
So that we can see the person. You're just building the tension for everybody in terms of the result. So please.
Maybe whomever I'm asking can put the video on so that everybody can see, because we are also live on Facebook. So a request to the applicants. So to start with, we have Shaunraj. Can you please switch on the video, Shaunraj?
I'm call my name last. I'll appropriately dress and come. You just call my name.
Okay. Fine. So I see Davamati smiling. Hi, Davamati. So Davamati, can you please share with us your experience over this concept? And maybe later Avinash can also answer the same.
Okay. So, the first thing when I look into before applying for any award is if we are eligible enough to apply for it. And that's exactly what I did when I finally decided to apply for the Educator Award. So the moment I glanced at the application, I thought it's going to take me some time because I had to get feedbacks from my peers, students, references from mentors, and also has to consolidate a lot of documents, but yet I wanted to do it. So at the beginning, I was self-nominating myself and therefore had to look into a lot of my previous achievements. So looking back on how far I have achieved or how far I have traveled, that gives a subconscious pride, which made me feel good about myself. So the feeling of participation in itself gives a sense of fulfillment and self-satisfaction, which is matters at the end of the day, I think so. So I would like to thank Optometry Council of India for providing me this opportunity, and also thank everybody who supported and motivated me throughout this journey. Thank you.
I think that's a great feedback, Davamati. The very, spirit of participation. I think that's really great, because I think in India, culturally, we feel that self-nomination is something, that we are not used to.
Yes.
I think that is hesitation. I found among all the award applicants, not only this award, even for the other awards also, we have found a lot of hesitation because people say, how can I self-nominate myself? And if you ask, even I would, if you put me in a position, even I won't do it. It is, I guess culturally, that's how all of us are. So, even overcoming that barrier and just going through the process of application itself, I think congratulations to each and every one of you for that. Great feedback, Davamati.
Rashmi ma'am, I'll add to that. In fact, I received a lot of WhatsApp messages that how can we apply? How can we self-nominate? There has to be some other way to, get this award. And that's what I had to, guide them back to your page and OCI that you can clarify from them. But there should not be any problem of self-nominating, especially when all of them are doing such a great job.
Yeah.
Thank you, Kim. Thanks for that. Seeing his Facebook page, I just got motivated. Okay, let me also try.
Yeah. I think that is something people need to kind of overcome. We don't consider ourselves good enough for something, I think that is, as I said, culturally, that's how we've all been, I think. And it's a great step to overcome that and, find every opportunity that comes your way and take it, grab the opportunity and go by whatever it offers. I think that itself is great.
Okay.
Avinash, you want to talk?
Yeah. Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I think I'll agree with you because I knew that there is something coming up like this, but one day I found a tag in Facebook where you put in me that's what triggered me. I said, wow, even I can apply for it. No, I come to this point because we have that kind of a mental barrier. Why self-nomination? And I also agree with what Daumati has told. We actually forget what all things we have achieved, what all things we have done. And just to talk about the process of application, in fact, it has covered up almost all the components as we apply for this award. And to be frank, it took me around 4 to 5 days to complete it. I had to go through all these processes. That's where I could note out, yes, wow, these are the things that I have done. And also, it helped me to reflect back and understand the help of my mentors, my teachers, who are there in this platform right now, my former colleagues also, because it's a team effort. With a team effort, you can't achieve this much. So all credit goes to my optometry team and fraternity. And in terms of the institution, I had one point, I think that was really helpful out at this point. Since I'm working at a newer institution where they have recently opened up optometry, they seem to be very much interested in developing this and understanding this. When I shared this with my higher ups, they were very much interested and they were telling, wow, there is a body which will actually see this. There is a body which will actually facilitate this thing, solicit to you guys. And optometry is a very serious business. It's a good academic program. So I think a nomination for this from an institute that actually has created a good benchmark for optometry compared to the other allied health programs over here. So I think this has to be done more often. And I think that's where the, especially the private institutes, they will get to know that is there is an overarching body which is taking care of all these things and we are responsible to that. And at the same time, it also gives them the sense that the profession of optometry, what we're doing is really serious one and we are all committed and we are working as a team. So the overall experience was great. Thanks for this opportunity, madam.
Great. I think Lakshmi, with the application process, it was like a refresher for everybody that, okay, kya kiya hai hum logon ne, let's go back, get back for the application. Nice to hear. Very nice. Great. So Divakar, I have the next question for you. So how do you feel on being selected as one of the top 10 applicants?
Thank you. It's really great feeling that I wanted to know how many had applied so that.
Lakshmi, can you please tell how many?
Yeah. We had around 22 applicants and we shortlisted 10.
That's really great to be in a top 10 list. And I thank OCI and as well as Bausch & Lomb for giving this opportunity. And one point I wanted to add is along with all those parameters, we also wanted to add a clinical parameter where as a teaching faculty, you should also be a good clinician. So as a part of what clinical work you're doing and what amount of clinical work you're doing, that can also be added as a parameter of assessment I was thinking about, because you can't be a good educator without a clinician. That's what I have learned from my mentors, that you have to be a good educator. Once you have a clinical experience, then only you can reflect that into your teaching experience.
Very, very good point, Divak, that you're covering. And I think KK also touched upon that, you know, when he was talking about skill and, knowledge sharing. So, yeah, absolutely good feedback, Divak. And you. I also want to say that from the 22, the reason why we had to, look at I would say not consider a few was because the applications were not complete. Something or the other were missing in the applications as well. So it was we had to go through a process of elimination and then after that select the top 10.
Thank you.
You're muted, Paula.
Usman sir, can you please share your thoughts too?
Yeah, sure. Good evening, everybody. I was very late to apply for this award. Yes, as Lakshmi said, I was probably hesitant. Ke 20 saal, 22 saal ki history nikal ke likhni hai mujhe CV mein aur feedback ke liye. Then I thought really have I given my 20 years of life as an educator? And my wife told me, you all optometrists are the educators who are actually not having a degree to teach, but you are there because of your courage and because you wish your profession to go ahead. So none of you have a B.Ed., B.Ed., M.Ed. degree with you as a teacher, qualified teacher, but you became teacher because you wanted your profession, your students to go ahead. And there is where you people are above all this, and you should surely apply. And then I started digging into my files and laptop, and somehow I probably matched the deadline for filling up the form and sending it. Thanks OCI and Boston Norm for giving us this opportunity to apply for, nominate our own self. And probably it's a mirror for our own self. Kya kiya hai aur aage kya karna hai? What we have done till date and what we have to do tomorrow for the profession. Thank you.
Who's the youngest in this group? Is it Noor or Ankit? I'd like to hear from the youngest in this group. Not you, Usman, for sure.
I think Ankit.
Ankit is the youngest, is it? Okay. Ankit, what do you want to talk to us about? Because I want to hear if I can say that the next generation.
Actually, ma'am, I am extremely thankful to OCI and Boston Norm. I know I am the youngest among all, and I am always get that motivated from all the great mentors like you all. Usman sir is one of them, from where I have learned many things. And I'm actually disappointed from all the faculties in India, because I think there are more than 100 plus gone with this educator award. But I would, because this is FB Live, I would like to think that at least should for the educator award in this, because I think my students are looking in me something, and they are getting motivated because of me, because they have never seen Usman sir or any other. At least like me, in each and every institute, they should have applied for this educator award. It is not important to be the best educator. At least we should apply so that our students get motivated from looking from our faculties itself. And I guess teaching, as rightly said Usman sir, teaching is actually changing from one transition to another transition, because initially where our teachers were a student, they were having a different scenario of learning. When we were student, it was a different scenario of learning. And when we are a teacher and when we are teaching our students, it is a complete different scenario. So it is a big transition which we have seen from almost 20 years. And actually, Usman sir have a teaching experience of 20 years. He have a very good experience how the teaching has changed, the learning has changed. So, yes, first of all, I should say to every educator faculty that if you are getting an opportunity to be present in an award, you should apply at least. Second thing, it is not an important factor whether you are a good educator or bad educator. At least you should apply. Third thing, let your students see how you are doing, what you are doing in a great platform which is given by OCI. So, and obviously Boston Norm, I would like to thank Boston Norm, because Boston Norm has given us the opportunity since when we were students, because Boston Norm has started one program that is MMIC, Mastermind in Campus. So from there, we are getting and learning exposure of contact lenses, so which was a very good initiative taken by them. And I would like to thank OCI, because in the previous year, they were having an award which was optometrist of the year, I guess. So as Avinash sir said that there should be a clinician, a good clinician also. So OCI have actually done a good job previously also, that there was an educator award, optometrist award, and this year we have an educator award. So I'm grateful for that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Ankit.
Yeah.
Lakshmi ma'am, we have a teacher-student duo and both are applicants. So I would just like both of them to, you know, just give us some feedback on the application process and the thought process. So we have Hiral and we have Noor. So
okay.
Hi, Noor. Hi, Hiral.
Hi. Okay. So
Hiral, you must be feeling proud ki aapka student bhi ek applicant hai.
Of course.
That was the reason I was hesitant to nominate myself.
And I wanted to apply because I wanted to, I was happy to see Noor as an applicant. It's just a feather in my cap to see Noor. You know, it's wonderful to see our own students competing, our own teachers. What a beautiful, you know, it's a visual treat to see our students. In fact, for me, it was an overwhelming, you know, experience because the moment I saw that I have to nominate myself, as likewise everybody said, it's a mental barrier. For me, of course, for a moment, it was a mental barrier because I knew there would be many takers. I right now also I'm seeing there are wonderful experienced teachers. Noor is in front of me. Then second challenge was that how would I get testimonies? I'm sure Noor knows what's my persona. Paula knows what's my persona. I have some of my peers and my students around who knows what's my persona. So I was really, you know, I was wondering kisko jaake poochu main. But then when I asked students and the kind of feedback what I got, I was like, okay, I have made a difference. Now, I think I can apply. Of course, it was the last moment I did it because the kind of feedback I got, I was literally touched. And I thank all my students. I thank you, you know, everybody. I thank OCI and Boschendom for giving this platform to recognize us. And today, whether I win or not, I think I'm already a teacher. I can see Noor in front of me. And I know from all the feedback, I have made a difference to someone's life to create such wonderful optometrist for the country. So this was wonderful. I mean, so yes, Noor, what do you think? You are muted, Noor.
I'm sorry. Yeah, I know many of you. I mean, I was literally very hesitant. In fact, I thought that how can I compete with the people, so eminent educators from whom I have learned, and now this I have to nominate myself for the Educators Award. But when I saw the form, then I realized when I went through that, I mean, I said, I thought that all these criteria which is mentioned there, I am able to fulfill that. Why not? Let's go for it and let's see. Because whatever, I believe that whenever, whatever we should do, especially as an educator, we should be doing at our best. So when we are doing our best on a day-to-day basis on each of our lectures, why not we should be hoping for the reward or the appreciation out of this, whatever we are doing. So I think, and this is a very good initiative to do that. Whosoever wins, I mean, it's a great, great thing that OCI is doing. At least it will motivate everybody and we can look forward for such awards and activities in future.
Actually, as I'm seeing, no, we have four great educators and all the top 10 applicants are all their students. Prema, KK, Ramesh, and Usman. In some way or the other, I think all four of them have kind of educated at some point or the other, all the applicants, all the top 10. So congratulations to all of you. I think all of you have been great, great mentors, Ramesh, Usman, of course, KK, as well as Prema. So thanks to all of you for having given such excellent educators of the future.
Great. Can we have Shondraj or can you just on your video, Shondraj?
Can you see me, ma?
Yes, yes, yeah, Shondraj, yes.
But this is Facebook Live, so I wanted everybody to see you. Yes. So,
First of all, I'd like to thank the council. I know the council is trying to put the optometry in the center stage, and then we are trying to get the recognition. The council is doing a fantastic job. They have recognized the clinician. They are doing the school screening activities. They are going, reaching out the public, educating about the eye awareness. And now they are finding out this educator award, which is fantastic. And I like to thank the sponsors as well. It's fantastic initiative. They are coming out facilitating all the educators. Now, I just want to say something about my personal experience with KK. When I was posted in a clinic, that time I was talking to KK, and then he said, what you did today in your clinic? I said, sir, I did this. And then one of the intern posted with me. And then I asked me, okay, what did you teach to the intern? I said, sir, I taught them retinoscopy, subjective refraction, things like that. Okay, why you didn't teach the other things? Why you didn't teach the fundus evaluation? Why you didn't teach the gonioscopy? Why didn't you teach the tonometer? I said, sir, they are just now came into the internship. Why should I teach them? And he said, Shunraj, unukku 5 vishayam theriyuna, 10 vishayam kattukudu. That means if you know 5 things, you teach them 10 things to your students. I think that is the motivation I always have with me. I don't know whether KK will remember this conversation or not, but I always tell to my fellow colleagues as well, as an educator, you know a few things, try to teach 10 things to your students. And I always feel that, and I always say to all my colleagues here, if you want to raise the optometry standards in India, the only way, one of the ways, not I won't say the only way, one of the ways by increasing the quality of education. And that comes from the educators like us. And we have to step up and teach our students vigorously, properly. And so that way we can improve the quality of optometry practice when they go out. And that way it would be beneficial for the overall profession. So that's what I wanted to say. I didn't take much time. Thanks to OCI for considering this.
Thanks to everybody. This is overwhelming that you have accepted us, you believed in us, and you have applied. Thank you very much. Lakshmi ma'am, you want to say something? I'm really overwhelmed.
Thank you, Pola, for all your support. So I think without further delay, because Noor is like getting tensed. Like, what is going to happen next?
Pola, I think there are a couple of more who are left or everyone has spoken. I'm just checking that. I can see Mumtaz.
We have Kritika left. Shenbagam, I think, is traveling.
Shenbagam is traveling. Mumtaz is not one of the applicants. And Nirav has just joined. I think as the school head, he has joined in the...
We have covered almost everybody. Kritika. Yes. So shall we move ahead?
Yeah, go ahead.
So yes, the tension has been building. It's been almost an hour. And we are all waiting for that one moment. And I invite Sanjay sir to please announce our winner.
Thank you Paula, but before I do that, I think really impressed with the comments made by Dr. Krishit Kumar. I think the amount of time he spent and the details he went through each application and his guidance to the educators, what should they be doing going ahead, so which would I think raise the bar for the award next year. Maybe it would become like more tougher if people like follow what he's saying. Thank you, Dr. Krishit Kumar. And before I announce the award, I think Dr. Kumar already kind of hinted on the winners, I think. And he said two people have done a good job. So there is a tie. And the four winners are Ms. Kritika Ramesh from Manipal College of Optometry. Very, very congratulations. And the joint winner is Mr. Avinash Prabhu from MIS Ramaya College of Optometry. Congratulations to both of you, and also to all the other people who applied And I was hearing really overwhelmed with the amount of work people had to do to apply for this award, because as I've already committed to Lakshmi ma'am that we would be continuing with this award for next year also. So there are like more opportunities coming in next year as well. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sanjayji. And congratulations to both Dr. Kritika and Avinash. And, this is also, Avinash, you were taught by Kritika?
Yes, she is my teacher. Yeah.
So imagine what's happened here. Huh?
Yeah, a teacher and a student.
Yeah, absolutely. Dr. KK, do you want to say a few words before I go on to Kritika and Avinash? So I would request both of them to say a few words. Before that, KK, do you want to say anything?
Yeah, I think first of all, I'd like to congratulate Dr. Kritika and Mr. Avinash. And of course, Kritika, I know very well from her undergraduate days and how she has shown her keen interest in while learning, as well as when she started imparting or facilitated learning. I see there are great transformation. I think she is the first one in Indian optometry who have applied for FIMA. And great thing about Kritika, now I could see that she could create another, like Mr. Avinash Prabhu. I think Avinash Prabhu, I'm really impressed with your documentation and the amount of information you have. And I feel this should be transformed to more and more faculty members around the country, not only within your institution. I think both of you should play some lead role and take the torch. You should become a torch bearer for Indian optometric educators. And we are all there around you as senior members to support you all the time. And OCA is always there. Why not? There should not be a famer like optometric education and research, something which you can put forth because you've gone through it. I'm really looking forward, and congratulations to both of you. Really impressed. Thank you.
Thank you.
Lakshmi, just a round of applause for both of you.
Oh. Good. Thank you, Paula. Well prepared. So, Kritika, so what's your feeling?
Hello, everybody. Good evening. First of all, thank you to CI and Bosch and Lomb.
You are another KK man. Such a saintly, calm. This thing, no excitement. Come on.
Yay!
KK, she's proven that she's your student.
And thank you, KK sir, considering me as one of the eligible person to get this award, and happy to share this with Mr. Avinash. He was a first batch of student when I started teaching at Manipal, first batch of master student maybe. Yes, when this award application came up, I was just thinking, but no second thought whether to apply or not. And it's a kind of helped me to reflect what I did last 10 years. So fortunately, this award also coincides with my 10 year of academic experience. As Dr. KK said, yes, even from my postgraduate days, I was very much interested in teaching. Rather than teaching, I should say, use the correct term of to facilitate learning. That was my passion. And once I entered academia, I realized it's not just teaching, it was multitasking, where we need to teach, do clinical work, as well as promote research. And the journey of learning do not stop with my post-graduation. Once I entered academia, I understood it's going to be a lifelong learning. I need to keep updating myself so that I can impart better knowledge for my students who are going to be the future educators. So I take this opportunity to thank all my gurus from my alma mater, both from Elite School of Optometry and Shankar Netralaya, who are great inspiration for me to take up teaching, and as well as I need to thank Dr. Siraj from Mahe, who was the real great motivation for me to take up the FAMER program in 2014, because in that batch, I was the only non-medical person to do that fellowship. And it was a tough time to complete that fellowship, because most of the terminologies, as an educator, we were not aware those times, even though we were doing most of the activities. And similarly, he opened up several opportunities for me to do another short-term fellowship from MGH Institute of Boston. So whenever there is an opportunity, he just calls up and asks, Kritika, do you want to do it? Just say yes or no, nothing more. So whenever I get an opportunity, I grab that and do that. So special thanks to Dr. Siraj and all the FAMER faculty. So even though the award is shared among the two, I feel it's just only a representation. We are only a representing phase of all the educators in the optometry. So with this, we need to work together, learn from each other, and do better for the optometry education, which in turn is going to give a better growth for the profession. And as Dr. Krishnakumar rightly said, the affective domain, which is much not given importance during the teaching, need to be given more focus, more than the knowledge and the skill aspects of the optometry. So without wasting much time, I thank OCI and Bausch & Lomb for introducing this award, and that helped me, yes, to reflect upon me, where do I stand as an educator. Thank you.
Thank you.
Avinash?
Yeah.
Your comments.
So, yes, I never saw that it's coming on the way. But it's good. It's good.
You know, just for the information of everybody, I had to visit Ramaya this morning to get some test done. And I met Avinash, incidentally. And it was very difficult for me to keep a straight face, okay, and not give out any clue. So I was like, I was telling Ajay, it's going to be really difficult for me to just keep shut about today evening's event. And I tried my best. Avinash, you got any clue?
No, ma'am. Never. I didn't get it. Okay.
Yeah, carry on, Avinash.
Yeah.
You're muted, Avinash. You're muted.
Yeah, I'm audible now. Thanks, thanks, Lakshmi ma'am, OCI and Bausch & Lomb for creating this opportunity and platform. And special, I would like to thank KKSA for mentioning FIMER. In fact, yes, that was one kind of an experience which opened up a different teaching learning method for me, where Dr. Sitik already told that's what I felt. Teacher is a lifelong learning process. It's not that today I learn, it's done. No, each day it's learning. And the amount of the kind of students that we get now, the amount of information they're exposed to, the accessibility that they're having current now, it's more of an information generation. So we should be very apt. We should know what we are telling and what we are doing. And that's where it calls for a lifelong learning. So all this kind of things I got in were through FIMER. And again, as mentioned earlier, special thank you to Dr. Siraj. He is a medical director and he is a founder of the FIMER at Manipal. He was one who actually helped me out and insisted me, Avinash, why don't you take it up this course? It really helped you out. And today I think that's one particular course which has helped me out to stand out from this. And yes, this things are just a representation. It doesn't mean that we got an award, rest of them are no. It doesn't mean we all are working as a team. And it actually gives me a sense of responsibility now. Okay, I have been recognized. I think I should do much more better. And I'm very sure that this recognition, which OCI and Bausch & Lomb has given, it will really give a good impulse across my university and especially to my students and my fellow colleagues. And I'm very sure that in the upcoming years, there'll be a very tough competition for all this kind of initiatives. And thanks to my mentors and my teachers who are there in this platform. And it was a wonderful experience. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, Avinash.
Thank you, and congratulations to the winners. Lakshmi ma'am, I invite you for the vote of thanks.
So thanks everyone for having gone through this process and, you know, spent your time being available today and sharing your experiences as well. And I think, you know, being an educator and sharing your knowledge, you know, in this competitive world, when you share whatever you know, like what Shonraj said, no, if you know five, teach the student 10 things. I think that is such a selfless process. You know, award, no award, whether you get recognized by, you know, as assistant professor and grow the ladder in terms of your positions, all that is all secondary. You know, I think a selfless sharing of knowledge is something, I don't know, I feel it's very, I don't know what word to use. I'm getting the word pavitra, pavitram, you know, it's a very, I can't get the English word for it, so pardon me. I think it's a very noble, if I can use that word, noble profession to be in, where you're selflessly sharing the knowledge that you have with the student, with no terms of return. Of course, it is a paid job, all that is there, but then you don't expect something in return from the student, right? And I think it gives great joy. I'm sure Kritika must be in cloud nine, not because she won it, because Avinash won it along with her. You know, that is something, I think that is what educators are today. So thank you. Thanks to each and every one of you. Please do continue to apply and also tell your colleagues also to apply next year. I think this is going to be a great inspiration for everybody to participate in the coming years. And thanks to Paula, who put this whole, you know, program together along with Kemraj. So both of us, both of them were discussing, you know, what to do. Shall we do this? Shall we do that? And all of that. So great, great work, Kemraj. You are always the silent person behind the scenes. So I should mention, you know, it's great effort from your side also.
Lakshmi ma'am, on a lighter note for KK sir.
Yes.
Karnataka doesn't.
Why are you calling me water. Ma'am?
Ah, sir, you have two awards.
Huh? Why are you calling me ma'am first?
No, this is okay, KK sir. Sir, uh-huh. Karnataka doesn't give Tamil Nadu water also. You gave them two awards. Not fair.
No. Now they are giving. Now they are giving copious amount. More rains, more water for us.
Good one, Prema.
All right, thank you. Wonderful show. Congratulations, all.
Thank you, Prema. So thank you, Sanjay sir, for having spent the time. And I think you've really groomed a great person in Kemraj through the organization called Bosch & Lomb. So I think you should be very proud of you know, the work he does and how he kind of coordinates such things. So thanks a lot to you and your organization. And as you said, thanks to, you know, saying that you would be supporting such initiatives in the future also. It means a lot to us as an organization and as educators, I'm sure. It really means a lot to all of them for you know, supporting the profession in whatever way you can. So thanks to you and all the attendees. And finally, a big thank you to KK. Thank you, KK, for having meticulously gone through all the applications, you know, read through each and everything that, you know, the applicants came forward with, and all the criteria that you put forth, and judging them according to that. So thanks to all the effort that you've put in. And yeah, you always are, like, as I said, a saintly person, you know, and I don't think I can ever achieve that ever in my life. You know, being so calm, composed, and you have a very good student in Kritika. I you know, after winning, the reaction she did, very, very, very quietly and calmly, you know, reacting to the entire thing. So you've built really great section of students, I should say, KK. Thanks to you for that as well. And Ramesh, you know, congratulations to you as well. I'm sure you've been a great support to Kritika in all the efforts that she does. Women are known for multitasking. So being a mother of two children, being a full-time educator, I'm sure, you know, you've been a great support to her as well. So thanks to you also, Ramesh.
A pleasure. It's a pleasure. It's a very happy moment for the Manipal team itself, you know, to have two of our bright alumni, bright Manipalites winning the award. Thank you to all. Pleasure.
Thank you. Thanks. And I think it's time that we close this event, unless and until anybody has anything to say. Thanks to all of you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Congratulations to the winners and
thank
everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.